Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to all of you. Welcome to Swa Education, myself Radha. And today we are going to discuss about barley processing, in which we are going to discuss purling, malting and brewing. And this lecture is mainly beneficial for the aspirant who are preparing for Telangana Food Safety Officer exam. So today we are going to target this portion. So before discussing barley processing, what is barley? Barley is a major world crop rank among the top 10 crop and is fourth among the cereal. Barley belongs to the genus Hordeum and can be considered one of the most ancient crop. So barley belongs to the genus Hordeum. So please remember it. Barley belongs to genus Hordeum. Processing of barley. Barley is often milled to obtain purled barley. We will discuss what is purled barley. Barley groat, barley flakes or barley flour for human consumption. So mainly we target barley purling, malting and brewing. So purled barley, what is it? A reference to the grain in which the bran layer has been removed. Let me show you. This is a grain and this outer layer is the hull portion. Outer hull, and it consists of fibrous content. Fibrous content. And in purling process, what we did, we remove this fibrous portion or we remove this outer hull or the bran layer. And due to this removal, what happened? Fiber content also removed. So a reference to the grain in which the bran layer has been removed. And the removal of bran layer or the outer hull portion result in grain with much less fiber content, which is less healthful than grain that retain the bran. So what is the advantage of this? The advantage of this is that pure barley take less time to cook as compared to the barley that is not pure. So pure barley cook faster, that is the advantage. But on the other side, because we remove outer hull portion that consists of fiber, we remove bran portion, just because of that, pure barley contain less fiber content. But that is the advantage, that it cook faster. So purled barley is a barley that has been removed or processed to remove its fibrous outer hull and polished to remove some or all of the bran layer. It is the most common form of barley for human consumption because it cook faster. So what happened in purling process? Removal of kernel outer layer, or we can say hull or bran and germ layer. Next one is, how is malt made? So this process is malting. So the process of malting involves three main steps. What is these three main steps? One is steeping. Second one is germination, and third one is kilning. In steeping, what we did, in steeping we take finest grain or barley and soak it with the help of water so that grain consists moisture content or optimum moisture content, and after that grain is able to germinate. If that grain did not contain optimum water or moisture content, that it is impossible to germinate of that particular grain. So first step is very necessary, that is soaking with the help of water. That is the steeping process. Then that grain is able to germinate, and then kilning, in which we will do air dry process. So the first is soaking the barley, also known as dipping. Two, convert the dormant grain, or we can say inactive grain, into active. Dormant means inactive. Next, the grain is allowed to germinate after stripping, then grain is able to germinate. Finally, heating or kilning the barley produces its final color and flavor. So first one is the stripping, second one is the germination, third one is the kilning. These are three steps of malting. Firstly, we take finest barley grain, then we soak that barley with the help of water, then that barley is able to germinate, then we will air dry that, and then rootlet removal, and then finally malted barley will produce. So what is it, steeping, germination and drying? Steeping, after we made sure that we are using only the finest quality grain. So first we make sure that we use finest quality grain, then we move on the first of the three stage known as wet process, that is called steeping. Steeping involves soaking grain in large tank to ensure that the moisture content is at an optimal 45% and the perfect level to create our premium quality malt. So as I told you that in steeping we soak that particular grain with the help of water so that that grain can contain optimum level of moisture content. After that, or containing moisture content, that grain is able to germinate. So aim of steeping is to get every grain to the same moisture content and ready for the germination. If that grain did not contain optimum level of moisture, it is impossible to germinate. Next one is drying. In drying, what we do, we drain the water and give the grain an air rest. So these are the three processes of malting. So this is our barley. Firstly, we take finest barley, then cleaning, then malt production. How we did it? First one is steeping, then germination, then kilning, and then finally malt production. And our third factor that we are going to discuss is brewing or beer production from barley. So after malt production, milling, wort production, and then wort clarification, and then fermentation, then secondary fermentation, then filtration, then packaging. So we discussed it, that what is these 9 steps. So 9 steps are involved during brewing process. First one is malting, that we already discussed, that it consists of 3 steps. Second is miling, then mashing, then lautering, then wort boiling, then wort separation and cooling, then fermentation, then filtration and carbonation, then packaging. So we will discuss all these steps one by one. So after malting, malt barley plus water. So after kilning is completed, the malt are then crushed between the roller to break the kernel of the malt into cotyledon, and making it easy to extract sugar during mashing process, impurities like dust, metal and stone will be separated. So in malting, we did 3 steps, steeping, where we soak that barley with the help of water, then that barley is able to germinate, and then kilning, where we will do air dry. After that, what will we do? Malt are crushed between the roller. Malt are crushed between the roller. Why? To break kernel of malt into cotyledon. Then mashing. The grain from the milling process are then mixed with hot water. Then that grain is mixed with hot water at 65 degrees Celsius for 1 hour to create a cereal mash. When mixed with hot water, starch get hydrolyzed by its naturally occurring enzyme, means breakdown of starch, and proteolytic enzyme break protein, and this conversion process is called saccharification. And then after saccharification, the sugar-rich liquid is obtained, which is called wort. Clear? In mashing, conversion of starch into simpler form of carbohydrate, that is called saccharification, that consists of sugar-rich liquid. Then wort boiling. Boiling is done for about 60 to 120 minutes depending upon the volume of water. So we boiled that saccharified mesh, that is called wort, for 120 minutes. Then wort separation and cooling. Solid particles from the wort are separated in a vessel called whirlpool or settling tank, and the vessels filled in the wort with the force into a center of the tank and are easily separated. So first what we did, first process is malting in with stipping, then germination, and then kilning, then myling, then mashing, and by the help of mashing, sugar rich liquid is obtained, that is called wort. Then we boil that wort, and after boiling we separate some solid particle from that wort, and then fermentation. Yeast are added when the wort is transferred to a fermentation tank. After wort separation, we transfer that wort into a fermentation tank, and after that we add yeast, particularly Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Fermentation can be carried out in closed vessel or open vessel. Then filtration and carbonation. In filtration carbonation, what we did, beer are carbonated by adding carbon dioxide under high pressure. Carbonation can also be done by addition of sugar, yeast and hop, and then packaging and bottling. So this is the process of brewing. So firstly, what we did, malting, in which we did three step: steeping, where we add water content into the grain, and so, or we can say soak the grain with the help of water, and then they are able to germinate. Then we do air dry, and after that process we did myling, in which what we did, we crushed that malt portion, and then mashing, in which sugar rich liquid is obtained. Then we boil that wort for 60 to 120 minutes, and then we separate that wort portion, and after separation we transfer that wort into a fermentation tank, and then we add yeast, that is Saccharomyces cerevisiae, into that fermentation tank, and then there is a formation of beer, and after that we carbonated that beer by the help of carbon dioxide, and finally packaging and bottling we did. So then mashing, then boiling, then cooling, and then fermentation, then filtration, finally bottling. So today we discussed barley processing, in which what we discussed, peeled barley and malting of barley and brewing of barley. I hope this lecture is very clear to all of you. So thank you so much everyone. If you find this video beneficial for you, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe this channel for more such kind of videos. And if you have any query regarding this lecture, you can comment down below. Thank you so much.